Hello, it's Joe here for Joyrider TV. This video is in answer to a question that I had from Danielle, and this was about how do you organise the bowsprit, spinnaker shoot, and jib furler on a Hobie 16. Well, we don't have any Hobie 16s which have spinnakers or furling jibs, but the arrangement on a Hobie Pacific is pretty similar. So here we are with a Hobie Pacific. So the bowsprit arrangement, this is just a very quick overview of how the bowsprit is attached. You'll need a fitting on your front beam where the bowsprit pins onto. And then the other end of the bowsprit is supported by the bridle wires, which come from the front of the bowsprit. And then we have intermediate bridles, which support the middle of the pole. And then in the middle of the pole, this is where all of the interesting stuff is with the furler. So we have the furler here, and the forestay attaches to the end of the furler. And then from the ends of the bridle wires, we take a rope through the tang on the bowsprit and then up to the other side so it's even. And then we're pulling a bit of tension on this rope, so we're putting a very small amount of bend into the bowsprit. What that amount of bend does is it means that when the spinnaker is under tension, under pressure, the bowsprit is never going to bend more than straight. If the bowsprit is allowed to bend upwards like a banana that way, that is when you could snap your pole. And then at the top of the jib, there we have a swivel so that that can rotate at the top there as well. And then from the furling drum, we have the line which comes back and cleats on the front beam. So the operation of the furler would be like this. We take the rope out of the cleat and then we pull on the jib sheet. And then there's our jib, very nice, ready to go. And then when we want to put the jib away, like we've mentioned before, if it's windy and you want to roll your jib, put your boat almost on a dead run, so with the wind from behind, that makes the jib roll easier. But if it's not so windy, it's not important what point of sail you're on. And then we just pull the furling line and the jib rolls thus. To complete the overview of the spinnaker system on here, so on this boat, and this would be the same on a 16, we're using a single line spinnaker hoist, which means for the tack we have a double block here. This goes forwards, one end of that is tied off round this block at the end of the pole using a bowline, the other end is going round the block, and then that's attaching to the tack of the spinnaker. From the other end of this double block, this is where the halyard is. So one end of the halyard is going through a block on the pole and then up the mast, through a block near to the top of the mast, and then down to the head of the spinnaker here. The other end of this line that's coming forwards is then coming back to the cleat on the front beam. This is what's going to hold your spinnaker up. And then back to a block on a piece of elastic on the trampoline. That block is going to keep that under tension so it doesn't get in a mess. And then through the trampoline, and that line is going to come underneath. This is the same line here, up through the chute, and that's what's going to attach to the retrieval points on the spinnaker so that you can pull it in. So that is a quick overview of the furling jib and spinnaker system on a Pacific, which would be the same as on a 16. One thing we could say when adding a furler is the bridle wires will need to be a little bit shorter. On the Pacific, because the furler is a standard, the stock bridle wires are the right length. But on a Hobie 16, let's take a look at a 16 now. So on a Hobie 16, adding the furler is going to put these bad boys further apart, which means that the mast is going to be further back. So the ideal there would be shortening the bridle wires here and having bridle wires with a fork end rather than a regular eye end. What I mean by a fork end, we're going back to the Pacific again, is so that the end of the bridle wire is like this, so that will go straight onto the furler there. Okay, so I hope that has answered your question, Danielle, and anybody else who happens to have been watching. If you do have any questions, I can make a short video like this answering your questions, because I do find it a bit easier than just typing the answer where things can be lost. So there we go. Thanks to everybody who's been supporting the channel. Do head over to totaljoyrider.com for a Give It The Beans t-shirt, because you need one if you've been giving it the beans, or if you're even thinking about giving it the beans, you need a Giving It The Beans t-shirt from totaljoyrider.com. See you next time.